The time to plan your affordable summer getaway is right now. Family travel experts Keith and Tia Sims are joining us live from New York. And by the way, he is a former NFL star, and they want to share their top five tips for having a fun and comfortable and also cost-effective RV vacation. Good morning to you.
Good morning. How are
you? Good morning.
I'm good. I'm good. My first question is, how in the world did you get into the whole RVing thing?
Well, it's all her fault, and she really blessed our family by bringing us into RVing.
Yeah, my husband was working in South Florida doing some broadcasting work during the season. And so traveling back and forth between our home in Atlanta, Georgia, and South Florida was starting to become a bit cumbersome. He's traveling and spending the night in hotels. And so I was like, you know what? This is my opportunity to plug my RV dreams and aspirations. So I told him, let's go ahead, purchase an RV, we'll place it down in South Florida. You can stay there while you're working, but then in the off season, let's travel so we can invest in our vacations. And I think that was like the best thing that we ever decided to do. Our kids have thoroughly enjoyed it, and we've just become so close as a family because of it.
I was going to say, you definitely get to know each other when you're in those close quarters,
oh, yeah,
kind of rolling
oh,
around.
Yeah.
So if you were to say, what would you say to someone who was thinking about getting into the whole RV lifestyle?
Oh, I would say definitely go ahead and do it. If you're curious about it, you need information, go to GoRVing.com. It's a tremendous website. It's packed with information, whether you want to rent an RV, whether you want to buy an RV. It'll help you choose the right one for you and your family. You can find campgrounds. You can find anything and everything you need to get started in the RV lifestyle. There's a wonderful blog called The Scenic Blog. We're actually bloggers for it. You can follow along with the bloggers there. You can get tips on where to go, follow their experiences, write down the recipes you can cook in your RV. So just get started today. Give it a try. One of the ways you can do it, if you're not wanting to rent or buy, is go to a campground. Find a campground. They have cabins and park models you can rent. All you need to do is bring your toothbrush and you can stay there, and you can get out in nature and experience the camping and RV lifestyle.
That's what I was going to say. What is it about RVing that kind of attracted you guys so much to it? What makes it so fun for you?
And that's the same question I got from all of my friends and family. No one that we knew was RVing or had RV'd in the past. So this was a brand new endeavor. I don't know what intrigued me initially by it, except for, you know, you would see the RVs out on the road and you just kind of got curious. I'm curious about almost everything. And so I said, you know what, let's go to some trade shows and some RV shows and check them out and see what's going on. And from that moment on, I was pretty much hooked, and I knew that we would love it. It was just a matter of convincing the big guy over here.
And for our family, the flexibility, the affordability has drawn us. It's brought our family closer together, and the experiences we have had, we've explored just a little bit St. Louis on our way to Mount Rushmore.
Oh,
and
went indeed.
To the Arch, and we love St. Louis so much. Sugar Fire
oh,
Barbecue.
My gosh.
Oh, he said the magic words.
Love it.
We had to go back to St. Louis just to have that barbecue a second time. And of course, the City Museum was just fabulous. We could have spent days just exploring that with the
kids.
Yeah,
I understand that for sure. Well, let me ask you this. I'm sure this is probably the main question a lot of people are wondering about is the affordability. What are the things that you can do to make it more affordable for every, you know, type of budget?
Well, there is an RV for every type of budget, whether you want a pop-up camper or a big Class A like we have. There's something for everybody there. And when you start figuring out the cost, particularly for larger families, we have three kids that travel with us, two in college that sometimes come along with us. And when you think about buying five or six or seven plane tickets, and then you need multiple hotel rooms, and then you're eating out all the time, we typically save a lot of money over airline travel, and allows us the flexibility not only to go from point A to point B, but we get to stop along the way and experience and explore. So it's definitely more affordable for most families.
And you get more bang for your buck because you're seeing more than, let's say if I plan to drive back out to St. Louis, I'm going to see more from point A in Atlanta to St. Louis than I would if I hopped on a plane and just flew there. So you're just getting an amazing value for the investment.
All right, Keith and Tia Sims, thank you very much for your time this morning.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. And don't forget to follow us on soulfulrvfamily.com. Check out our adventures. And then come along and go RVing with us.
All right. Sounds good. You have a good one.